Hello, welcome to Ecoholics. Today we'll be solving a question that has come in a lot of exams, the Kuhner model. So we'll be solving a numerical of the same. In the year 2020, in the Indian Economic Service, this question was there. Let market demand faced by duopolist be P is equal to 100 minus 0.5Q, where Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, which is the quantity supplied or produced by the two firms collectively. And their respective cost functions, C1 is equal to 5Q1. So this is the cost function for the first firm. And C2 is equal to 5Q2, which is the total cost function for the second duopolist firm. We are to find the Kuhner-Nash equilibrium. In order to solve for Kuhner-Nash equilibrium, what we have to do is we have to find out the reaction curves. Reaction curves of both the firms 1 and 2 will be found out through the use of profit function of both the firms individually. Now, when we maximize the profit value of the first firm and we maximize the profit function of the second firm, we get what we call as reaction curve of the first firm and reaction curve of the second firm. In the Kuhner model, we don't have to do a lot of things extra. We just have to equate the two reaction curves and we get to know the quantity which will be set by both the firms, firm 1 and firm 2. So let us remember this is a quantity setting model and let's solve this ahead. So this is the numerical that we have. We have the demand curve and we have the cost functions. The first thing we do is to find out the profit function of the first firm as well as the profit function of the second firm. The profit function of the first term is denoted by the sign. So the profit is always equal to the total revenue of the first firm here minus the total cost of the first firm. So the total revenue is always equal to price into quantity that this firm is going to supply. So taking the price function here and inserting the same here, we get 100 minus 0.5 Q. Now Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. So we'll be inserting this value, Q1 plus Q2. And we will be taking the multiplication with Q1. So this is the total revenue for the first firm. And we can always subtract the total cost, which is 5Q1. So now we'll multiply this function and simplify the same. We have 100Q1 minus 0.5Q1 square minus 0.5Q1Q2 minus 5Q1. We can combine these quantities and write it as 0.5 minus 0.5 Q1 square plus 95 Q1 minus 0.5 Q1 Q2. So this is the simplified profit function of the first firm. Now, in order to know the reaction curve of the first one, for the first firm, we will be differentiating this profit function with respect to x1. Let's do the same. Now we have the profit function of the firm 1. We will differentiate this with respect to q1 and we will get the reaction curve. While differentiating, we will put this equivalent to 0. So we get delta pi 1 upon delta q1. So 0.5 into 2 q1 plus 95 minus 0.5 Q2. So this is a simple first order derivation of this profit function. We get Q1, so there was a minus sign here, plus 95 minus 0.5 Q2 is equal to 0, or we simply say Q1 is equal to 95 minus 0.5 Q2. We mark this equation as 1, and this is the reaction curve of firm 1. Now we can understand that this function is telling us that for every different quantity of the second firm, the first firm will have a requisite quantity that it will put. So this is the reaction to A's to the second firm's behavior by the first firm. So we have to remember this, and now we find the profit function and the reaction curve of the second firm. Simply, we can also remember that considering that the total cost function is having almost the same value for both the first for both the firms, we can simply replace the values. We can interchange the values. Q2 is equal to 95 minus 0.5. Q1 will be the reaction curve of the second firm, but it is always better to go for a complete description of the same method. Let's do the same. Now we have the total profit function of the second firm, which is total revenue of the second firm minus the total cost incurred by the same. So we have price into quantity set by the second firm minus total cost of that firm. So now we've inserted the value of price from the question itself, right? This is the question itself. We are just inserting this value here. We multiply this with Q2 and we continue with the function here. So here we get 100 Q2 minus 0.5 Q1 Q2 minus 0.5 Q2 square minus 5 Q2. So we can condense the same, we can simplify the same. So we get 95 Q2 minus 0.5 Q1 Q2 minus 0.5 Q2 square. So this is the simplified profit function of the second firm. And now we have to find the reaction curve. So simply we will go ahead with the first order differential of the same here. So we have this profit function, which we are going to differentiate with respect to Q2. So we get 95 minus 0.5 Q1 minus Q2 is equal to 0. The same method that we just applied for the first firm. And from here, we can find the reaction curve of the second firm. So we get Q2 is equal to 95 minus 0.5 Q1, right? So the same simplified values that we had done earlier. So let's mark this as the second equation of our interest. We have the reaction curve of both the firms, and the Cournot model simply states that both the firms will be acting naively. They will be taking into consideration what quantity was put by the firm earlier, and they will continue to make the decisions accordingly. So to solve it numerically, we simply have to combine both the reaction curves together. So two simultaneous equations and two variables will be solved together. So we now have the two equations together. We can insert Q2's value here in the first equation, or we can put Q1's value in the second equation. So I'm going to put Q2's value in the first equation. I'm writing this as 1 by 2. We get 95 minus 0.5 Q1, and we have 95 minus 47.5 minus plus, so we have two minuses, so we have a plus sign now, 0.25 Q1, and this is equal to Q1. So combining the terms, we get 0.75 Q1 is equal to 95 minus 47.5, which is nothing but 47.5 itself. And we have Q1 is equal to 47.5 upon 0.75. So in the examinations, we are allowed a calculator, so we can use the same here. So the value somehow comes out to be 63.3333. So this is a continuous value here, so we can put a bar. So the first firm is getting 63.33 as its quantity. This is the quantity that will be supplied by this firm. The same value we can insert in the reaction curve of the second firm. So we will come to know what will be the value or quantity that the second firm will decide to put. So we get, if I simply put it here, we get 95 minus 1 by 2, 63.33, and the value comes out to be the same. Both the firms will be having the same values. So we can simply write the quantity set by the second firm as 63.33. So now we have the quantities set by both the firms. We should also find out the price function, add these quantities, and also the profits for both the firms. So let's do the same. So we now have the price function and the quantities that we just found out for both the firms. Let's put the values here. So we can see that the two quantities have become equal. So this Q, which is equal to Q1 plus Q2, becomes either 2Q1 or 2Q2. So let's put this value, and the value of Q1, Q2 is 63.33. This is a 0.5 function, so we can make this as 1 by 2. This gets cancelled, and we have 100. Minus 63.33, this value comes out to be 36.67 approximately. So this will be the price that will be set by both the firms in this model. Now we have to find the profit of the first firm as well as that of the second firm. So profit is price into quantity set by the first firm minus the total cost of the first firm. So price is 36.67 and quantity set is 36.33 minus the total cost. Total cost was 5 into Q1. So Q1 is 63.33. We could have taken out 63.33 and ease the calculations. So again, we will be using calculators in the examination, and the value comes out to be 2005.67 approximately. So solving this entire value, we get 2005, which will be the profit by the first firm. Similarly, we will find out the profit for the second firm. The profit function for the second firm. So here we have price and quantity by the second firm minus the total cost by the second firm, and we have the price, which was 36.67, quantity was 63.33, minus the cost function. So we are already aware that these functions and values have been the same for both the firms. So we can simply say that the profit will be the same, or we can solve this individually. We have 5 into 63.33. The total cost function was 5x2, right? So I have written down the solve values for these numbers. So the multiplicative value comes out to be this. And for this function, this is the multiplicative value. The other way of solving the same is taking out the common term, the quantity, right? So we have this term which is taken out, and we are left with the first term minus the second term. So we have this condensed value, right? So this comes out to be 31.67. The final value again comes out to be 2005.76 or 67. So this is the approximate value that will come. So here we have solved a question from Kuhno equilibrium. How firms find their quantity when they follow non-collusive pricing, specifically the Kuhno assumption of firms taking the other firm's behavior as constant. And we can also see that here the firms, they are maximizing their own profits, but if we find out the joint profit of the industry, it is not going to be maximized. So this is it for now, and I hope you liked our video. Please like, subscribe, and share our channel, Ecoholics. Have a good day.